Good morning, Steve Whiteside here. It's Monday, June 6, 2011. Well, the markets have opened this morning, and the major indexes are down for the most part. We've got the NASDAQ up a couple of points, but it looks like we're going to see downward momentum on Monday. Now, Friday, we saw downward momentum, so we're very oversold on a short-term basis, and we were overbought on the VIX. The VIX came back into the middle of the range, though. So we're going to start out this morning just looking at 60-minute charts. That's our focus for today. Because we're nowhere near daily buy signals on the major indexes. The VIX has been trading above and below the flypaper channel. So if we stay above 1740, we should look for lower stock prices. If we can start moving down below 1680, then I think the trend will start to move higher for stock prices. First sign of strength for the VIX on Monday, if we start closing above 1840 on an hourly basis, that would give us a new intraday buy signal and be supportive for lower stock prices. Looking at stock prices, starting with the S&P 500 cash index, you can see we got down to the bottom of the panic zones. We've got a nice pressure zone there. We are still projecting lower prices, unfortunately. So if we are going to move higher, then we would expect that the flypaper channel would act as resistance. That is currently in the 1322 to 1328 level and dropping. And for an hourly buy signal on Monday, we need to close above 1310.89. That level will continue to move lower on Monday. Take a look at the NASDAQ 100, similar situation, projecting lower prices, but we do have a pressure zone. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones. This is where we look for low-risk buying opportunities. Any buying opportunity would probably fail up at the 2340 level. We needed an hourly close above 2317.32, and that level continued to drop on Monday. Looking at bank stocks, and I still think bank stocks are the key. I know technology stocks have done a great job of holding this market up, but I really think that we could see some dramatic moves to the downside for bank stocks. On Monday, we're currently oversold. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones. We're still projecting lower prices here. If we do move higher, notice the last couple of times we moved higher, we've been able to move above the flypaper channel, but basically have not been able to break away. So it looks like we've just, as soon as we break through and start trading above the flypaper channel, it's like the bank stocks start to fall asleep. They nap and then just fall off the edge, and there we go once again, further lower. And so if we are able to move up on Monday or Tuesday, then a move up to the 139 level would not be unreasonable. First sign of strength for bank stocks on Monday is an hourly close above 134.75 for the S&P Bank Index. Looking at gold stocks, different picture. We got a sell-off last week, but not down to the extremes that we saw in the other indexes. And looks like we made a higher low last week. So we've got the pressure zone there. An hourly close above 204.27 on Monday would give us an intraday buy signal for the XAU. Take a look at index charts, just a couple. Want to focus on the VIX. The VIX has had that huge pressure zone down at the bottom there. The VIX has had that huge pressure zone down at the bottom of the screen. And since that pressure zone formed, we've basically not been able to make any headway. We are still projecting higher prices up to the 24 level. We've got the open gap just below that, and that could act as resistance. If we start closing below 1626, then that's a new sell signal. That would be supportive for higher prices for the stock market. But we were trading above the upper channel line on Friday. And so we've been able to penetrate the 1875 level once again, but have not been able to close above it. And so there's a lot of other charts that are sort of in the same range as the 1875 level. Down at the bottom, we've been trading in this range. If we start breaking down below 1563, that would be very supportive for higher stock prices. The midterm channel is up just under 20 right now, so we really need to break out above 20 to get a midterm buy signal, but we're still waiting for a breakout above 1875. Notice the oscillator down below. It's basically flatlined for the last couple of weeks, and I think it's going to be moving higher from here. So once the VIX gets rolling, I think we're going to see a huge move to the upside once it breaks out of this range. Looking at the daily flypaper channel chart, you can see that we've been able to punch through the top of the channel a couple of times. But again, we need to close above 1875 to take us above the top of the flypaper channel chart. Last two charts this morning, the US dollar index was able to make a new low for this move on Friday, and the euro was able to make a higher high for this move on Friday. So a close above 75.42 is what's needed to give us a buy signal for the US dollar index on Monday, and a close below 141.90 is what's needed to give us a sell signal for the euro on Monday. Okay, that's all for Monday morning. We're oversold on a short-term basis. We're nowhere near getting daily buy signals on Monday. We need to get intraday buy signals first before we'll get close to getting daily buy signals. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.